Hello everyone, today we are going to see the third chapter in geography, which is our changing earth. In the last class we have discussed about introduction part, endogenic forces and exogenic forces. Then we have seen endogenic or endogenous forces. Then we have seen tectonic plates. Then we have discussed about tectonic activity. Under this we have divergent boundaries, convergent boundaries and transform boundaries. Then we have seen earthquake. Next, causes of earthquakes. Synopsis of the lesson. In this session we are going to see the following topics. The first one is earthquake, volcano, effects of endogenic forces. Under this we have spreading zones, subduction zones. Then we have exogenic or exogenous forces. Under this we have waterfall. Students, in the last class what we have seen? Earthquake, right? So here we can see the pictures of earthquake. What is mean by an earthquake? An earthquake is a sudden tremor. Tremor means shake or movement of the earth's crust, which originates naturally at or below the surface. An earthquake can be compared to the effect observed when a stone is thrown into the water. After the stone hits the water, a series of concentric waves move outwards from the center. Something similar happens inside the earth, which causes earthquakes. There is a sudden movement within the crust or mantle and concentric shock waves move out from that point. The place or point of origin of the earthquake is called the focus or hypocenter. So what is mean by focus or hypocenter? The place or point of origin of the earthquake is called the focus or hypocenter. Since this is often deep below the surface and difficult to map, the location of the earthquake is often referred to as the point on the surface of the earth directly above the focus. This point is called the epicenter. The point on the earth's surface directly above the focus or hypocenter. The strength or magnitude. Here, magnitude means size of the shock waves, determines the extent of the damage caused. It can be easily understood that the damage would be more severe in places close to the epicenter and lesser at places which are away from the epicenter. Students, do you know Charles Francis Richter was an American seismologist? First, we have to know what is mean by seismology. Seismology is the scientific study of earthquakes. Then we have to know who is a seismologist. Seismologist is someone who studies the sudden violent movements of the earth connected with earthquakes. So Charles Francis Richter was an American seismologist and physicist. So what is mean by physicist? Physicist is an expert in or student of physics. He was famous for the creation of earthquake measurement scale called Richter magnitude scale. This scale is used for measurement of all earthquakes across the world. So students, the strength and magnitude. Magnitude means size of an earthquake is normally measured on the Richter scale. The strength of an earthquake measured less than 2 on the Richter scale may not be noticeable to human beings, but those above 7 can cause major damages to structures and landforms. Sometimes strong earthquakes with epicenters in the seabed can cause huge tidal waves which could have devastating effect on seashores. So here devastating means causing great damage. Such phenomenon means occurrence or event. So such phenomenon means occurrence or event is known as tsunami. So what is mean by tsunami? Huge tidal waves caused by volcanic eruption or earthquake below or very close to the sea floor. Students, here we can see the picture of tsunami. So students, what is a tsunami? A tsunami is a large ocean wave usually caused by an underwater earthquake or a volcanic explosion. Tsunamis are not tidal waves. Tidal waves are caused by the forces of the moon, sun, and planets upon the tides, as well as the wind as it moves over the water. With typical waves, water flows in circles, but with a tsunami, water flows straight. This is why tsunamis cause so much damage. Volcanoes. Next, we are going to see volcanoes. Students, here we can see the pictures of volcanoes. Students, first we have to know what is mean by volcano. Volcano means a vent in the earth's crust through which molten material erupts suddenly. Here, erupts means of a volcano become active and eject lava, ash and gases. So, a volcano is an opening or rupture. Here, rupture means break or crack on the earth's surface or crust, which allows hot molten rock, ash and gases to escape from below the surface. Students, do you know where does the word volcano come from? Have you ever thought about why volcanoes are actually called volcanoes? Can you think of a reason why? The word volcano comes from the island Volcano, which is a volcanic island in Italy. Here we can see the picture of Volcano Island. It is situated in Italy. The island actually gets its name from the Roman god of fire, Vulcan. Students, do you know there are two active volcanoes in Europe? The first one is Mount Vesuvius near Naples in Italy, and the other one is Mount Etna on the island of Sicily. So students, here we can see the picture of Mount Vesuvius as well as the picture of Mount Etna. The lava flowing out of a volcano has a very high temperature. It ignites. Here, ignites means set fire to, or in other words, ignites means starts burning. So, it ignites means starts burning nearly everything on its path. This lava later cools down and forms igneous rocks, as you studied in the previous chapter. So students, the picture of a volcano and a sketch of the cross-sectional view below would help you understand how a volcano erupts. In the first picture, we can see cross-sectional structure of a volcano. Here we can see side vent, crater, ash and gas. On the other hand, we can see main vent, lava flow, layer of lava and ash. Then finally, we can see magma. On the other picture, we can see volcanic eruption. Next, we are going to see effects of endogenic forces. Having seen the effects of endogenic forces, which are sudden in nature, now we will see how the slow movement of the lithospheric plates causes changes on the Earth's surface. The figure below self-explanatory. Self-explanatory means easy to follow and easy to understand. The great mountain systems of Earth, like the Himalayas, are a product of the collision. Collision means crash of lithospheric plates. Similarly, the huge trenches here, trenches means a narrow hole found on the ocean floor, like the Marianas Trench, are caused by plate interaction. Here we can see the picture of Mariana Trench. Next, we are going to see spreading zones. Rising through rifts. Rifts means crack or break in the crust. Dense magma from the Earth's interior, which means inside or inner, creates a new surface on undersea mountain ranges. So here we can see the picture of sliding plates. Next, let's see about subduction zones. First, we have to know what is mean by subduction zone. The subduction zone is the place where two lithospheric plates come together, one riding over the other. Here we can see the picture of subduction zone. Forces created when two plates push against each other, build mountains and cause earthquakes and volcanoes, thereby adding new material to continents. Next, we are going to see exogenic or exogenous forces. Exogenic refers to external processes and phenomena that occur on or above the Earth's surface. Weathering, erosion, sedimentation, etc. are exogenic processes. Let us see these one by one. First, we are going to learn about weathering. Weathering is the breaking down of rocks into small pieces by various effects of nature like wind, water, temperature variations, etc. So what is mean by weathering? Weathering means the breaking down of rock into smaller and smaller pieces. Here we can see the picture of weathering. Next, let's see about weathering by the wind. As the wind blows, it picks up small particles of sand and blasts large rocks with the abrasive particles, cutting and shaping the rock. Here we can see the picture of weathering by the wind. Next, we are going to learn about erosion. Erosion is the removal of solids, which means sediment, soil, rock and other particles in the natural environment. It usually occurs due to transport by wind, water or ice. So students, erosion refers to the transportation of rock, soil and mineral particles from one location to another. Erosion is different from weathering since erosion as the moving element, the main driving force behind all agents of erosion is gravity. Without gravity, the other major natural agents of erosion such as wind, running water, glaciers, waves and rain would not occur. The process by which water, ice, wind or gravity moves pieces of rock and soil. When rock is weathered, weathered means broken into smaller and smaller pieces. These pieces are often carried away by water, wind or ice. So students, here we can see the picture of erosion. Next, we are going to learn about sedimentation. Sedimentation is the collection and deposition of eroded and naturally transported material. So as a whole, we are going to learn about weathering, erosion and deposition. First, let's see about weathering, the breaking down of rock. Weathering agents include water, wind, ice, animals, growing plants. Next, let's see about erosion, the movement of sediment from broken rock. Erosion agents include water, wind, ice, gravity. Next, let's see about deposition, the dropping of sediment in a new place. Examples of deposition are formation of an island, sand dunes. Landforms are affected by movement of water as well as ice and wind. Students, let us see these one by one. Now, we are going to learn about waterfall. Here we can see the picture of waterfall. A waterfall is a place where flowing water rapidly drops. Here, rapidly means quickly drops from an elevation as it flows over a steep region or a cliff. So what is mean by cliff? It is a mass of rock that rises very high and is almost vertical like a wall. This causes a lot of erosion. For example, take a mug of water and pour it on the soil outside your house. See how it makes a hollow, which means hole. and removes some sand or soil from where it falls. So students, imagine how much of erosion would take place if tons and tons of water falls from huge heights. Students, do you know the tallest waterfall in the world with a fall of 807 meters is located in Venezuela. This waterfall is known as Angel Falls. So students, here we can see the picture of Angel Falls. Students, do you know Victoria Falls on the Zambezi River in Zambia is famous as the largest waterfall of the world, although it is neither the highest nor the widest. It is considered largest because of forming largest sheet of falling water. Waterfalls for 108 meters at the center. So students, here we can see the picture of Victoria Falls. I have enclosed the classbook instructions in the PDF. Kindly refer it. So now, we have reached the end of this session. Thank you.